We have an Excel file with projected and actual sales data. There are three scenarios in the projected data: best case, worst case, and normal case scenario. Data contains monthly sales, cost, and profit figures. The actual data contains sales, costs, and profits of same store, on same month and dates. We will create a dashboard based on this data. We will compare each scenario with the actual data. The actual data will always remain the same. Filters will only change scenarios to compare with the actual data. To start with our project, first we will import the data from Excel file. We will let the import process complete. From the Navigator window, we will select both sheets and press Load. We will let the data load into the Power BI desktop application. Once the data is loaded, all the tables and their fields will be available in the data pane. There are many ways to achieve what we want. However, today we will use the data modeling technique. Let's go to the model view to create a data model. Here we already have both tables side by side. We will link the date field of both tables. In Create Relationship window, we will keep the default settings and press OK. Now the relationship between these two tables has been created. Now, we can go back to the report view and create a dashboard based on this model. Let's start our dashboard by creating a title using a text box visual. Inside the text box visual, we will enter the title of our report. Now, we will make it bold and change the font size to 36. Finally, we will properly place the title at the top of the report. We won't be using any filters, so let's hide the filters pane to make more room for our report. Now, let's add years from date to dashboard as slicers. However, there is no hierarchy in our date field. This is caused by our data model. As you can see, it is same here. We can change the cross filter direction from both to single with projected filters actual settings. Press apply changes. Now the date in projected table should have hierarchy in both model view and the report view. Let's enter the date field to our dashboard as a slicer. We will change the slicer style to drop down. Let's place the slicer on the top of the dashboard, right next to the title. Next, we will add the scenario field to our dashboard as slicer, changing its style to tile. We can place it next to our date slicer. The date slicer will help us display data of 1 year. And the scenario slicer will help us choose the scenario which we want to compare to the actual data. Now we will add the actual cost to our dashboard and the actual profit as well. We will change the visual to a pie chart. We will place this visual at the top right corner of the report. Let's change the titles of value fields to something appropriate. Make a copy of the existing pie chart. Replace the value fields with the cost and profit fields from the projected table. Rename these two with appropriate titles. Let's add a scatter chart to our dashboard. We will place this chart at the top right corner of our dashboard. Let's make some minor adjustments to our visuals. Let's add the cost and the profit fields from the projected table. Select Do Not Summarize for both fields. This will display projected data in a scatter chart. As you can observe, the actual data is not changing. Now, we will add a line and clustered column chart to our dashboard. Add the sales fields from projected and the actual tables to the column y-axis of the line and clustered column chart. Add the profit fields from both tables, the actual and the projected, to the line y-axis of the line and clustered column chart. Add the date field to the x-axis, removing the quarter and the day from hierarchy. Change all these fields into average from sum. This will display all items once, including actual values, which are displaying three times due to repetition. Make a copy of the line and clustered column chart and place it at the bottom right corner of the report. Replace the sales fields with the cost fields as average. Remember to change them into average instead of sum. Our dashboard is now complete. As you can see, during all three scenarios, the actual data remains unchanged, which was our primary target, to compare all projected scenarios to the actual data. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials and updates.